Professional wrestling is something that has always been viewed as a sideshow. Since I was 5 years old, I grew up a fan of the business. I was fascinated with the characters and the action in the ring. At one point, I did want to become a professional wrestler. Unfortunately, times change, but my fandom and love for wrestling never did. Due to the highly secretive nature of the business, I was looking to get a view behind the curtain. I was looking to hear from the men and the decision makers behind putting together a wrestling promotion. In seeking out information regarding independent wrestling promotions that were local, I came across Texas Wrestling Entertainment. An independent promotion based out of San Antonio, Texas, the organization was originally under the banner of Texas Wrestling Alliance, which was co-owned by the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, and Rudy Boy Gonzalez, who acted as the head trainer of the academy. After Michaels departed back to wrestling full-time, Rudy Boy stepped in as the owner and operator.
From the far west rodeo in San Antonio, Texas, where on March 21st, it was history. The incredible showdown left the fans of the TWA with a feeling that they have only seen the beginning of the wild side of professional wrestling. This is the TWA Total Impact. I'm Kevin Vargas, the afternoon host of 99.5 KISS, and Stipulation CEO Venom said you were allowed back at the broadcast table, Shawn Michaels.
Thank you very much, Kevin Vargas. You know what? A 30-minute show is not enough to show everybody what happened at the Incredible Showdown, but we're going to do our best.
Welcome, Rudy Boy Gonzalez!
Rudy Boy is a legend in Texas wrestling, competing all over the Lone Star State.
Well, there's not a passion for Rudy Boy here out of the San Antonio fans.
The man has worked with and trained some of the best talents to ever step inside the squared circle. Guys like the Brian Kendrick, Paul London, and perhaps the most beloved wrestler in modern wrestling, Daniel Bryan.
What are you working on, Josh?
Looking at the questions.
Looking at the questions, getting ready for your interview.
Yeah.
Talk about the movie.
Oh, well, this documentary is meant to chronicle my journey to uncover, you know, the world of professional wrestling, because it is a very... it's a world of secret. There's a very, very few outsiders that are allowed into it, and in this case, I'm going to be given a small taste, if you will, of that outside world, and I'm going to be hopefully willingly presenting my findings to whoever views this documentary, because I feel that is important. If you're a fan of the product, it's good to know exactly what goes behind putting it together, because it's a very fascinating process, in my opinion, at least from what I've read and stories I've heard. So I want to be experiencing it firsthand, and I look forward to seeing what I find.
We have our own little crew here.
Yeah,
with Steven's helping.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you, Josh.
And then Karina's also here.
I was going to ask you, bro, out of the indie show tonight, what are you expecting to talk to? Like, who kind of questions you think you might ask? Like, what exactly are you trying to find out, I guess?
Well, what I'm trying to find out is basically, I want to know more about the talents. I want to know more about the issues they have in general. what the pay is like. I'm going to try, hopefully, not to offend anyone because I don't want to denigrate their craft because, you know, if they don't make much, you know, it's tough. I mean, they're doing it because they love it. So I don't want to step on too many toes, but I am going to ask them personal questions about what the rigors are of being on the road constantly, what the challenge, the stress of being on the road. Of course, one issue I also want to uncover more about is definitely there has to be an end game to what it is they do. So is this a long-term career? Is it a hobby? How do you get along with the boys in the back? You know, who determines who gets put over on what given night? You know, there's a lot of different things that go on into putting on a show of this magnitude. So I just want to find out what I can get my hands on and hopefully not ruffle any feathers. Because unlike that one man in that great Nolan movie, I don't like to rattle the cages.
Mm-hmm.